realized that I talked to 617 women who said they were Annie's mother, and 619 men who claimed they were her father. That makes, let me see.
1,236.
All liars. Drake, I never realized there were so many dishonest people on the island of Manhattan.
Some of them were from the Bronx, Miss. Grace, we're back.
Where are they, Miss Farrah? Where are all the people? They're gone, dear, come and gone. I'm sorry, but they're nothing but fakes and liars after nothing but $50,000.
Are you certain?
Yes, sir. None of them knew about the locket. I'm so sorry. Gee, I thought for sure somebody was going to be my mother and father.
Sir, this has just arrived by a special messenger from the FBI. Wonderful. Elliot Ness is located the manufacturer of Annie's locket in Utica, New York.
Oh, boy!
That sort of locket was manufactured between 1918 and 1922.
Sort of locket?
Yes. Over 90,000 remain sold.
90,000?
Afraid that the gist of what Ness is trying to say is that he doesn't think there's a chance in a million of finding your locating your parents through the locket. I'm sorry.
That's okay. I mean, gee, you did the best you could. If you can't find them, nobody can. Anyway, I guess a kid can get along without folks. You didn't turn out so bad. You got everything. All them Duesenbergs hanging on the wall and everything. Excuse us, sir. We'll go check on the dinner menu.
Annie, a Duesenberg is a car. Babe Ruth is a right fielder for the New York Yankees, and there's something else I think you should know. I made me a fortune, that fortune made sense. Then headlined and profiled again and again. But something was missing each time I got through. That something was someone, but who? My speeches are greeted with thunderous acclaim, and soon universities marry my name. Yet something was missing, I never quite knew. That something was someone, but who? Who could that someone be? How could she make it known?
Oh,
okay?
I'll go get them right away, sir.
No, wait, I want you to stay for a moment. Oh, I haven't waltzed like that since J.P. Morgan went bust. Annie? I want to adopt you.
Adopt me?
Yes or no?
If I can't have my real mother and father, there's no one in the world I'd rather have for a father than you, Mr. Warbucks.
Drake?
Yes, sir.
Tell Mrs. Buehler there'll be a house full of guests. And make sure you have Justice Brandeis call. Ask him if he can come over and sign those adoption papers.
Yes, sir.
Tell Mrs. Buehler to be ready for a party. We're going to need flowers.
Flowers?
Caviar?
Caviar?
Champagne?
Champagne.
Annie, this isn't going to be an adoption, it's going to be a celebration. And you can have anyone in the world you want to come with. Who would you like? Babe Ruth? Johnny Rockefeller? Adam Shanghai-shek? She's a lot of fun.
Well, I guess I'd like the Sparrow here, and Mr. Drake, and Miss Pugh and Cecile, Annette, Miss Greer. Well, I guess I'd like everybody here.
Of course, I'd like that too. Drake!
Yes, sir.
Tell the staff to get spiffed up. They're going to be guests at Eddie's adoption party.
Yes, sir.
Oh, and the kids!
No, it'll be far past their bedtime. But I'll tell you what, we can have the whole orphanage here tomorrow for Christmas.
Miss Hannigan, too?
Why not?
Excuse me, sir. Everyone is getting, and these are your words, sir, spiffed up for the party.
I guess we ought to get spiffed up, too, huh? Grace? Grace? Have Cecile put Annie in one of her new dresses? And... Well, Cecile, that's Grace, that's a very pretty dress.
Thank you, sir.
Have Cecile put Annie in one of her new dresses and have Annette do something with her hair. And I don't know, well, gussy her up.
Gussing her up, gussing her up, gussing her up, gussing her up. Anna, Anna, Anna.
Everything's off from now.
Hum, hum, hum.